This scene will describe the roles of ecdysteroid and juvenoid hormones in regulating the events of molting and metamorphosis. Insects grow only during the time between the molts, so it is important that they monitor their growth progress to initiate metamorphosis after the appropriate larval instar. Therefore, insects require a body structure to serve as a marker for measuring when the larvae have reached their last instar and are ready for pupation. Such a marker must count instars and not be enlarged by growth. The structure must be fixed in size at the start of the instar, does not increase as the rest of the body enlarges during the instar, but jumps to its next discrete size at the start of the next instar. The head capsule is such a structure. The sclerotized head capsule enlarges only at the start of each molt and stays at that fixed size until the next molt. Larval insects monitor the head capsule width, and when it reaches a specified size at the start of the instar, the larva initiates metamorphosis at the next molt. For Manduca, that critical size is 5 millimeters. How head capsule size is determined is uncertain, but may employ stretch receptors. Insects may monitor food consumption as a means to regulate molting. In hemimetabolous species, the onset of molting is stimulated by stretch receptors in the intersegmental muscles of the body wall. When a large meal is consumed, so that growth of the next instar will be sufficient, the stretch receptors notify the brain to release prothoracicotropic hormone that stimulates ecdysone production by the prothoracic glands and increases ecdysteroids to initiate molting. If both juvenoids and ecdysteroids are present in the instar prior to molting, the subsequent instar remains a nymph. If juvenoids are absent when ecdysteroids are present, the resulting instar is an adult. Juvenile hormone is produced again for vitellogenesis in egg formation by adult females of most insect species. Here is a graph for the relative titers for ecdysteroids and juvenoids at the molts in holometabolous insects. Juvenoids are high in embryos prior to egg hatching to ensure the first instar is a larva. As in hemimetabolous species, juvenoids are present at each larval-larval molt through the fourth instar to ensure the resulting instar remains a larva. When the head capsule of the new larva attains the critical size for the species, it is the final larval molt, and a low titer of juvenoids present with the ecdysteroids results in a pupa. At the pupal adult molt, juvenoids are absent when ecdysteroids are released, and the imaginal discs are activated to undergo growth to form adult structures, and adult genes are expressed in the epidermal cells to form adult cuticle. Holometabolous species form a pupa when juvenoids are low at the last instar larval molt, and an adult when juvenoids are absent at the pupal adult molt. The appearance of an instar depends on the protein synthesized by the epidermal cells and is a function of endocrine-regulated gene expression. The next scene will discuss some of the physiological markers for holometabolous metamorphosis and the endocrine-dependent events that prepare the larva for metamorphosis.